If you're struggling to write podcast show notes, if you're struggling to turn audio or video into text, I'm going to save you a ton of time and I'm going to show you this awesome tool that me and my team over at my podcast agency have been using. It's called Castmagic. Let me share my screen. And listen, if you don't have 5 minutes to watch this video and learn this new software, I don't know what to tell you. Tell your wife that you're going to spend Sunday nights still doing the same damn thing that you've been doing. But instead of ruining your relationship and your marriage, I'm actually going to save it right now. I'm going to show you this tool. It's going to take 5 minutes. All right, smash like, let's go. Okay, cool. So this tool is called Castmagic. I'm gonna have a special link for you to save a few bucks in the description below. But as soon as you get logged in, you're gonna see where you can start to upload your recordings. I'm gonna show you how this looks in just a moment. You can see I've already uploaded some recordings here. And I wanna show you a few things here on the interface that I have found unique and helpful. So one of the things that you can do here is you can add speakers. One of the problems I've had using AI audio to text apps is that it sometimes struggles to determine who is speaking. And by using this feature, it's gonna better help the app to know who's speaking and when. That's a really annoying thing is when the AI will attribute a certain sentence or business or something to the wrong person. This item here allows you to kind of solve that. For settings, there's a couple cool things you can do here too. So when it comes to descriptions and transcriptions, again, AI is not perfect. And one of the problems that AI can sometimes run into is it doesn't know what, like it'll sometimes confuse words. So like my last name, Savant, it'll sometimes call me servant. And so by adding in magic words like Savant, it better helps me to, identify those words. So now it knows it's Savant, not servant. So that's helpful. Another cool thing here that it does automatically is it's going to give you by default a bunch of different pieces of information: titles, speaker bio, introduction, show notes, timestamped overview. Like this is amazing, amazing stuff. Newsletter, keywords, key topics, bullet points. I'm telling you, this software is really, really special. But another one of the cool things that you can do here is you can add new custom prompts. And this is basically telling the AI automatically, hey, I want you to do this with every episode. So let me show you something that you might do as an example. So one of the names I might add for a prompt might be email to guest. So maybe I want to send an email to my guest after the podcast is recorded, but I'd like it to be a little bit customized. I can simply go in here and say something like this. Let me fast forward. So in this prompt, I'm asking it to thank the guest for joining the podcast, highlight a key point from the episode that I thought was really impactful, or i.e. the AI thought was really impactful, and invite them to share any of the assets that they like. I'm gonna go ahead and save this prompt here. And what this is going to do is after I've uploaded my audio, it's gonna automatically give me that prompt. Pretty, pretty, pretty cool, okay? What else is on here? And you can of course invite team members on here as well. So one of the things that you will notice here at the top end here is there's three different ways that you can upload your videos. One is, well, you can just upload the audio or video file directly. You can use YouTube or you can use Descript. And one of the cool things with Descript is all these softwares have a limitation with the amount of minutes or the amount of uploads. So for example, with Castmagic, you pay per minute. So for every minute that's transcribed, you're paying. But if you use Descript, you get a 50% discount. So for all you Descript lovers out there, which is another app that me and my team really like, especially for editing video, if you're synchronizing Descript with Castmagic, you're gonna save some dough. But what I'm gonna do here real quick is I wanna show you this YouTube feature. I think this is really interesting, especially if you're trying to create interesting content for like a backlog of YouTube videos. So I'm gonna click on this YouTube button here and all I need is the YouTube URL. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna go over to my YouTube studio, and thank you for subscribing, by the way. Like this channel is freaking blowing up, just unbelievable. Very close to monetization, so I appreciate you there. I appreciate you. It's gonna be fun to look back at this in a few years and look at this time. Anyway, long story short, here's a video that I need a transcription for, I need description for, okay? So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make sure it's unlisted so it can be found. I'm gonna go ahead and copy that video link and I'm going to paste it here into Castmagic and submit. Now, it's gonna take probably about 5 minutes to process it. So while it's doing that, I'm gonna go grab a cup of coffee and I'll be right back. Okay, so we're back here and it's asking a few different details. Again, this is important because you want to give the software as much information as possible so it gives you the best transcription. So speakers expected, you're of course gonna have Mark Savant. Let's see if I can scroll down here. Okay, so the app is asking me for a little bit of information. Castmagic needs its information to make sure we get the best information possible. So number of speakers expected, it's gonna be 2. I'm also gonna type in a couple more keywords here. Neil Patel, let's do that. I don't know why it's doing this, but we're gonna fix this here. All right, and gonna go ahead and save the recording. Okay, so we are just gonna be processing here for a minute and I will go grab that coffee and I'll be right back, all right? Coffee's done and our transcription is done. Let's go ahead and check this out. You're gonna be amazed at how cool this is. So let's go ahead and click on it here and let's see. So the first thing it's asking us here is to match our speaker. So I'm going to first match speaker 1 with Mark Savant. Mark Savant. I know I'm already in here. I don't know why it's asking for this again, but. All right, so we have myself here, speaker 1. And speaker B is gonna be my main man, Neil Patel. I'm gonna add him, okay. Neil Patel. And he's the guest, save speaker. All right, so we've got our speaker A, speaker B. So let's kind of go down here. I wanna kind of show you some of the cool stuff that's going on with the transcript. So B, you've got all the transcripts, which by the way, for YouTube is really important. We definitely want that transcript, right? That's an important thing. And then next we're gonna go down here, go up here. We're gonna download that transcript because I need to upload that to my YouTube video. That helps YouTube algorithm and indexing. Next, we're gonna go over here to AI content tab. And well, it's still generating, but what we're gonna see here in just a moment, it's gonna give us all this information. It's super, super dope. Okay, cool. So all of our AI content is generated. And again, this is pretty cool, pretty cool here. So A, it's gonna give us a bunch of titles here, a bunch of potential titles that we can go through, right? It's gonna give us a bio of our speaker, which is pretty good. You know, I gotta be honest with you. Typically when I'm getting a bio, I recommend just going straight to the person's website to find the best, most relevant information. One of the challenges that this is gonna have here is I don't actually do bio read-offs in my episodes. I get them in my onboarding packet. Anyway, introduction, useful. Again, you can modify in different ways, which is pretty cool. The show notes plus short blog post, I think is really, really important. Right, because this is gonna break down kind of the key concepts, right? How did Neil scale his business to 700 team members? Mark asked Neil the importance of accessibility and communication with team members. I mean, this is exactly what the video is about. It also gives us some key takeaways, right? Which again, super, super relevant. Short blog post. So again, this is useful too. If you're trying to convert this into a website, or a blog post for your website, super, super valuable. One thing I would recommend is changing every few words or so. That's a useful thing to do. Timestamped overview. This is relevant too, especially on YouTube where timestamps help people move to and from important places. Now keywords, tons and tons of keywords here. This is a little bit overwhelming. I'd probably go through here and just grab like a couple, like maybe team members or vertical integration. Again, it's kind of grabbing a lot of keywords, AI, Elon Musk. I might pull out some key points there. Key topics and bullets, obviously relevant. This is pretty cool too, Clip Finder. For anyone who's making clips, you know, if you're trying to find little hooks and stuff, like this is a really easy place to say, hey, where do I want to take out clips from my videos, right? It's very, very, very useful. My team is definitely using this a lot. It's giving you an email newsletter. Right? It's giving you a LinkedIn post. Like, how much time do you actually spend doing this? And it's saved by using an app like Castmagic, Real Script. I mean, Tweet Thread, Discussions, Threads by Instagram, Email to Guests. So this is one of the custom prompts that we actually typed in here. All these other prompts come by default, but this is a custom prompt. Let's read what it says. Thank you, Neil Patel, for joining us on the After Hours Entrepreneur Podcast, your insights on scaling a business and transitioning from serving mom and pop businesses to working on major companies like Amazon, Microsoft, and Airbnb were truly impactful. Your emphasis on the importance of providing exceptional work and building relationships, blah, 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 blah. We would love for you to share any assets, blah, blah, blah. So, I mean, this is pretty cool. This is pretty good. Now, I could just come in here and copy and paste this. You're probably going to want to customize it a little bit based on your relationship, but this is basically all you need right here. This is kind of the key point here for your show notes description for YouTube is like right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy this. I'm gonna paste this into my video here. And you know, it's basically good to go. I'm gonna come through here and I'm gonna clean this up a little bit, but you know, you can see how quick and easy that is. I wanna also show you this magic chat, which is interesting. This is kind of like a ChatGPT style chat where you can ask it questions. So for example, I might say, please give me YouTube titles, focus on keywords, AI, business development, and Neil Patel. And let's see what it's going to give us back here for YouTube titles. Okay, cool. So basically within the course of 5 seconds, it's given us 10 different YouTube titles. So Unlocking Business Development Strategies with AI featuring Neil Patel. Neil Patel's expert insights on AI powered business development. What do I like here? Mastering AI for business development, innovation and business development, ladder. So as I look through these, one of the things I noticed is these are not like super shocking. When I'm looking for YouTube titles, I want to be a little bit more shocking. So let me say, please give me 10 more examples, but be more shocking. Let me actually use shocking and compelling. Use the term 700 employees also. Let's see if this gives us some better results. Okay, so we got some results here. Whoa, these are great, but these are way too long. These are basically useless. We cannot have prompts that are this long. Shorten the titles to less than 60 characters. Now I'm giving it some pretty difficult criteria, but obviously these are just way, way too long. Let's see what else it can do for us. So again, you can see I'm just kind of playing with this a little bit. Give me a YouTube title that uses keyword Neil Patel and is compelling and is under 60 characters. So listen, I'm going to spend the next few minutes kind of working through this and finding the perfect title. Honestly, I'm pretty freaking good at this. I've been doing this for a long time. So I'm probably just going to do something like this and then like a shocking thumbnail. But this gives you an idea of how you can use a program like Castmagic to really expedite your content production. So go out, make it happen. Thanks for subscribing to the channel and liking this video. You got a question? Did I miss something? Type it in the chat. I'd love to hear it. And link below. Go check it out. See you in the next video. Peace.